Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. I am Dr. Mangesh Dushi and this is the fourth lecture of IR spectroscopy. In this lecture, we will learn factors affecting the IR frequencies. Friends, in last lectures, we have seen all the frequencies for most of the function groups. The frequencies of the function groups are constant because the attaching atoms, the strength of bonds, the order of bonds are same. So frequencies are almost same. According to the Hooke's law, the stretching frequency of the chemical bond depends upon the bond strength and reduced masses of the atoms forming the bonds. According to Hooke's law, the vibrational frequency is directly proportional to the bond strength, that is force constant, and it's inversely proportional to the reduced masses of the atoms forming the bonds. So if bond strength is higher, vibrational frequency will be higher, but if reduced mass is higher, bond frequency is small. Any factor which will increase the bond strength will increase the stretching frequency of the bond. And if the mass of the atoms forming a chemical bond is increased, the reduced mass will increase and stretching frequency will decrease. Because vibrational frequency is directly proportional to bond strength, force constant, and inversely proportional to the reduced masses of the atoms forming the bonds. For any functional group in an organic molecule, since the types of bonds and the atoms involved are fixed, the stretching frequency at a given functional group, the stretching frequency at which a given functional group absorbs should remain same. So for a functional group, types of atoms, types of bonds are same. So their absorption frequency also same. See here. So all these are ketones. So ketone absorbs in between 1705 centimeter inverse to 1710 centimeter inverse. As all the normal ketones absorb the same frequency, types of atoms, types of bonds are same, they absorb the same frequency. That's why IR spectroscopy is used for the identification of the functional group, because the same functional group gives a same stretching frequency or absorb the same stretching frequency and gives the peak at that same frequency. That's why this can be used as a detection of the functional group. That is the use of IR spectroscopy. However, the other structural features many times modify the stretching frequency of the functional group in the molecule and hence its peak positions into the IR spectrum. So some of the structural features, some of the structural effects may modify the structural frequency. The other structural features or other structural effects many times modify the structural frequency, stretching frequency of the functional group. And because of that one, the position of the peak into the IR spectrum may get slightly changed, either towards the lower side or either towards the higher side. Consider the CO bond stretching frequency of the following compound. See here, all these compounds like hexafluoroacetone, acetone and acetophenol. All these molecules contain carbonyl group as a functional group, but their chemical environment is different. Fluorine shows a minus I effect, methyl shows a plus I effect, while this benzene shows a plus R effect on this carbonyl group. So this modifies the normal frequency of ketone. That ketone is absorbed 1710 centimeter inverse, just saw in last slide. So that modified little bit. See here, normal ketone absorbs at 1710 centimeter inverse, but if there are electronegative atoms are attached, then it shifts towards the higher frequency, that is 1769 centimeter inverse. If there are electron donating effect is there, then it shifts towards the lower frequency, that is around 1690 centimeter inverse. So in this way, these are the structural effects modifies the stretching frequency of the normal ketone. So this happens in most all the functional groups. The structural effects, the structural features modifies the stretching frequency, and that's why the peak positions in the IR spectrum will get changed, slightly changed. There are mainly four different factors which either increase or decrease the normal values of the stretching frequencies of functional group into the molecule. Those factors are inductive effects, resonance effects, hydrogen bonding and steric effects. So because of these structural effects, that is inductive effect, resonance effect, hydrogen bonding, steric effect, ring strain, these effects modifies the stretching frequency of the functional group, and position of the IR spectrum will get slightly changed. We will learn one by one now. First, we will start the inductive effect. So the group which have an electron donating inductive effect, when attached to the functional group, decrease the stretching frequency. Decrease the stretching frequency. For example, acetaldehyde and acetone. So acetaldehyde has a 17-20 centimeter inverse frequency, while acetone has 17-10 centimeter inverse frequency. The additional plus I effect in the acetone decreases the carbonyl stretching frequency. The plus I effect actually decreases the double bond character of the carbonyl bond, or increase the single bond character of the carbon oxygen bond. As we know that, according to the Hooke's law, vibrational frequency is directly proportional to the strength of bond. Directly proportional to the strength of bond. If double bond is there, double bond is more stronger. If single bond is there, single bond is less stronger. And triple bond is the strongest bond into the all three, single, double and triple bond. So as in general idea, we have seen that single bonded compound absorbs frequency around 1100 centimeter inverse. Double bonded compounds absorb a frequency around 1600 centimeter inverse, while triple bonded compound absorbs around 2200 centimeter inverse. So as the multiple bond character increases, it absorbs at higher frequency, and as the multiple bond character decreases, it absorbs at lower frequency. So in here, see here, here is only one plus I effect, well there are two plus I effect. So because of that one, what will happen? See here, this is the carbonyl group, and this carbonyl group has a plus R effect. So this pi electrons going to the oxygen. Now carbon has a positive charge, carbon has a positive character. This positive character is stabilized by the 2 plus R effect, by the 2 plus I effect in case of acetone. So this positive character is much stabilized, but this bond, double bond character decreases to the single bond character. So the frequency of the IR will get decreased because double bond character is shifted towards the single bond character, and that single bond character is stabilized by the plus I effect. Well, this is not in case of acetaldehyde. In acetaldehyde, there is only one plus I effect. So stabilization of this carbocation will be less as compared to the acetone. So the single bond character in case of acetaldehyde is less rather than the single bond character in case of acetone. In case of acetone, the single bond character is more. That's why its frequency is less, because single bond is a less stronger bond as compared to the double bond. That's why as the vibrational frequency is directly proportional to the bond strength, so bond strength in case of acetaldehyde is more because it has a more double bond character as compared to the acetone. That's why acetaldehyde absorbs at 17-20 centimeter inverse, that is higher than the 17-10 centimeter inverse for the acetone, that is ketone. So one thing is clear from this one, the structural effects which increase the double bond character or triple bond character will increase the IR frequency, IR stretching frequency. But if that structural effect decreases the multiple bond character to the single bond character, then IR frequency is also decreases, because vibrational frequency is directly proportional to the strength of bond. A minus I effect should increase the double bond character of the carbonyl group, and hence increase in stretching frequency of the carbonyl group. So plus I effect increases the single bond character of the carbonyl group, while minus I effect increases the double bond character into the carbonyl group. So plus I effect decreases the IR frequency, while minus I effect increases the IR frequency, IR stretching frequency. So normal ketone that absorbs at 17-10 cm inverse. Suppose this methyl hydrogens are replaced by the fluorines. Now fluorine has a strong minus I effect. So because of this minus I effect, whatever positive charge on this carbon atom, carbonyl carbon, is slightly unstable, is more unstable. So it don't go into the single bond character, it remains into the double bond character. It remains into the double bond character. That's why the double bond character increases. As the double bond character increases, strength of the bond increases. And as the strength of bond increases, the stretching frequency of the carbonyl group is also increases. So as the minus I effect goes on increasing, the stretching frequency of the carbonyl group is also goes on increasing. So that's why, see, in acetone there is a plus I effect, normal ketone absorbs at 17-10. But because of this minus I effect, strong minus I effect, the double bond character of the carbonyl group is increases, strength of the double bond of the carbonyl group increases, and it absorbs at higher frequency, higher wave number, that is 1769 centimeter inverse. So as the inductive effect, that is minus I effect, is increases, the stretching frequency is also increases. See, in case of chlorines, if there are two chlorines, so this is carbonyl chloride, so there are two chlorines, so minus I effect is higher, so it absorbs at higher frequency as compared to this two, so that is 1828 centimeter inverse. Now fluorine has a strongest minus I effect than any other electronegative atom, so it absorbs at higher frequency, that is 1928 centimeter inverse. So because of strong minus I effect, so minus I effect increases the double bond character, strength of the double bond of carbonyl group. That's why it shifts the stretching frequency towards the higher frequency. So frequency will get increased. So in short, the plus I effect decreases the stretching frequency of the carbonyl group, while minus I effect increases the stretching frequency of the carbonyl group. Now we'll see the resonance effect. So idea is same, which increases the multiple bond character, strength of the bond increases the stretching frequency, and the effect which decreases the multiple bond character decreases the strength of the bond, then IR frequency is decreases. The groups which have an electron donating resonance effect plus R effect when attached to the functional group should decrease the stretching frequency. And groups which have electron withdrawing resonance effect should increase the stretching frequency. For example, a alpha beta unsaturated ketone. When carbonyl group is conjugated to the carbon-carbon double bond, which has an electron donating resonance effect, which decreases the double bond character of the carbonyl group. And hence, this decreases the stretching frequency of the carbonyl group. See here, so this is the normal cyclohexanone, normal ketone. So it absorbs at normal frequency, that is 17-10 centimeter inverse. Suppose that is alpha beta unsaturated ketone, alpha beta unsaturated cyclohexanone, then it absorbs at lower frequency than the normal frequency. So it absorbs at 1685 centimeter inverse. Why? Because of this plus R effect, because of this plus R effect of alpha beta unsaturated double bond or this alkene, those electron goes over here, while this pi bond will break and those electron goes to the here. So double bond character of this carbonyl group will decrease. It has a more single bond character. So double bond is more stronger than single bond. That's why this absorbs at lower frequency, because it has a single bond character, more single bond character, and single bond is less stronger than the double bond. That is the reason the plus R effect in case of alpha beta unsaturated ketone decreases the vibrational frequency, decreases the stretching frequency of the carbonyl group. So in short, the electron donating resonance effect attached to the functional group decreases the stretching frequency, while the electron withdrawing resonance effect increases the stretching frequency. Because of this resonance effect, the double bond character moves towards the single bond character. Now this is the second example. In case of amines, the electron donating resonance effect of the nitrogen is far exceed than its minus I effect, and therefore the carbonyl stretching frequency decreases considerably and has a lowest value, that is 1690 centimeter inverse, as compared to the other carbonyl compounds. So in case of amines, means suppose carbonyl group is attached to the amine, so amine, that functional group becomes amide. So in case of amide, this carbonyl carbon is attached to the nitrogen. This carbonyl carbon is attached to the nitrogen. Nitrogen is an electronegative atom. It has a minus I effect. But nitrogen has a lone pair, unshared electron pair. So it has a more plus I effect rather than the minus I effect. So plus R effect is more stronger. And because of plus R effect, this double bond character converts into the single bond character. Bond strength becomes less. So IR frequency is also lowest, that is 1690 centimeter inverse, as compared to other carbonyl compounds. So amides are absorbed at a lower frequency, at around 1680 to 1690 centimeter inverse, because it has a amine group which has a plus R effect. So plus R effect decreases the stretching frequency of the carbonyl group. If the number of amine groups are increased, for example urea. Now in urea there are two amine groups, so two lone pairs on the nitrogen. So what will happen? Plus R effect is increased. As a plus R effect increased, so single bond character will increase into the carbonyl group and frequency will decrease around 1660 centimeter inverse. So in this way, as the plus R effect goes on increasing, the vibrational frequency, the stretching frequency of the carbonyl group goes on decreasing, because bond strength goes on decreasing. For example, this benzamide. So in case of there is a benzene ring as well as amine group, so there is a plus R effect, so vibrational frequency is 1680 centimeter inverse, which is slightly higher than the amide, because plus R effect of the benzene is less than plus R effect of the amine group. That makes this difference. All acid derivatives show decrease in carbonyl stretching frequency if there is an additional conjugation effect. So acid derivatives like ester. So ester carbonyl frequency will get decreased if there is a plus R effect is attached to the carbonyl group. For example, CH. So this is the ester functional group. So this carbonyl group absorbs that stronger frequency rather than ketone. Why? Because this carbonyl carbon attached to the oxygen, and oxygen has a minus I effect. So because of this minus I effect, it increases the vibrational frequency, it increases the double bond character in this carbonyl group. That's why it increases the vibrational frequency, that is 1740 as compared to the normal ketone. Now normal ester absorbs at 1740 centimeter inverse. But if that is attached with the conjugation alpha beta unsaturated ester, then what will happen? It has a plus R effect. So because of this plus R effect, the double bond character of this carbonyl group will decrease. The strength of this carbonyl group bond, carbon oxygen bond, that will get decreased. So it absorbs at lower frequency, that is 1720 centimeter inverse. As this plus R effect increases, then double bond character is also decreases, and it absorbs at lower frequency, that is around 17-15 centimeter inverse. So in this way, the plus R effect decreases the stretching frequency of the carbonyl group, while minus R effect increases the stretching frequency of the carbonyl group. Now next example is hydrogen bonding. This is the next structural effect. Now we will see how that hydrogen bonding affects the stretching frequency of the functional group. For example, carboxylic acids. Carboxylic acids are solid or pure liquids form, usually exist in a dimeric form due to strong hydrogen bonding. In dimer of carboxylic acid, the strong hydrogen bonding weakens the carbonyl bond, thus lowering the carbonyl adsorption frequency. The appearance of carbonyl stretching frequency at 17-21 cm inverse, that indicates that acid is largely in the hydrogen bonded or dimeric form. Carbonyl adsorption frequency in case of carboxylic acids is around 1740 to 1750 cm inverse. It's like a ester only. But because of this hydrogen bonding, see, this is the hydrogen bonding. So one of the hydrogen of one carboxylic acid is hydrogen bonded with the carbonyl oxygen of the another carboxylic acids. Similar case over here. So these carboxylic acids are present into the dimeric form. These are the dimers, two molecules hydrogen bonded with each other. And because of this one, what will happen? This double bond character is get decreased because of hydrogen bonding. Because of this hydrogen bonding, this bond becomes weak as compared to the normal carboxylic acid carbonyl group. So it absorbs at lower frequency, that is around 17-21 centimeter inverse. So this is the hydrogen bond and it absorbs at 17-21 centimeter inverse. Because of this hydrogen bonding, there is the resonance also. See here, if this pi bond goes over here, it forms a single bond. So this single bond will break, this goes over here. So here will be the double bond, this double bond goes over here. So here will be the single bond. So it means that double bond character of the carbonyl group shifted towards the single bond character. And that is the reason the strength of bond of the carbonyl double bond is decreased and the frequency is also decreased. So if the carboxylic acid absorbs at 17-21 centimeter inverse, it clearly indicates that the carboxylic acid is present into the hydrogen bonded form or dimeric form, because normal carboxylic acids absorbs at 1740 to 1750 centimeter inverse, but it absorbs at lower frequency, that is 1720 to 1721 centimeter inverse. It indicates that our carboxylic acid is present into dimeric form and hydrogen bonded form. Due to the hydrogen bonding, not only carbonyl frequency decreases, but OH stretching frequency is also decreases. The OH bond length increases due to hydrogen bonding and hence its bond strength decreases. Because of this hydrogen bonding, normal OH bond length is increased. As the bond length is increased, the strength of bond is decreased. As we know that vibrational frequency is directly proportional to the bond strength. If the bond strength is decreases, vibrational frequency is also decreases. So normally that OH frequency absorbs at 3200 centimeter inverse to 3600 centimeter inverse. But because of this hydrogen bonding, it strength is decreased, so vibrational frequency is also decreased. So see here, the OH which has a hydrogen bond, the stretching frequency is around 2500 to 2700 centimeter inverse. And without this hydrogen bonding, the OH stretching frequency is around 3500 centimeter inverse. So because of this hydrogen bonding, the strength of OH bond is decreased. And as the strength of OH bond is decreased, it decreases its stretching frequency also. So it absorbs in between 2700 centimeter inverse to 2500 centimeter inverse in IR spectrum. See, this is the one more example, that is para hydroxy benzoic acid. So this has a hydrogen bonding like this, intermolecular hydrogen bonding. So IR frequency is decreased, that is 1665 centimeter inverse, because there is a plus R effect is also there and hydrogen bonding is also there. Because of this plus R effect and a hydrogen bonding, the IR frequency decreased more as compared to the dimeric form also, that is around 1665 centimeter inverse. So this is the example for intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Now we will see the example of intramolecular hydrogen bonding, that is orthohydroxybenzoic acid. So in orthohydroxybenzoic acid, the phenolic OH, the H is hydrogen bonded with the carboxylic oxygen. So there is an intramolecular hydrogen bonding. So it decreases the IR frequency, decreases the double bond character of the carbonyl group. So decreases the IR frequency of the carbonyl group, that is around 1678 centimeter inverse. So in this way, hydrogen bonding decreases the IR frequency of the carbonyl group as well as IR frequency of the hydroxyl group. If hydroxyl is hydrogen bonded, it absorbs at 2500 to 2700 centimeter inverse, and if carbonyl group is present into dimeric form, it absorbs at 1721 centimeter inverse as compared to the normal carboxylic acid that absorbs at 1740 to 1750 centimeter inverse. Now we'll see the effect of dilution on this hydrogen bonding. If you increase the dilution, so what will happen in case of hydrogen bonding and what will happen with the absorption frequency, stretching frequency of the carbonyl group as well as OH. When IR spectrum of the acid is recorded with a dilute solution in a protic solvent, so that there will be no hydrogen bonding, the intermolecular hydrogen bonding effects decreases due to intervening of the solvent molecules, and as a result the OH stretching frequency shifts towards the higher value, that is 3550 centimeter inverse, and the carbonyl group stretching frequency also shifts towards the higher value, that is 1760 centimeter inverse. So while taking the IR spectrum, if you dilute that solution with the aprotic solvents, so hydrogen bonding with the solvents will get reduced, as well as intermolecular hydrogen bonding, that is also will get disturbed. So these two molecules of the carboxylic acids are separated by the solvent molecule now, because dilution is more. So because of this solvent molecule, there is no hydrogen bonding at all. So if there is no hydrogen bonding at all, then these bonds, OH bond or carbonyl bonds, having a normal stretching frequency. The normal stretching frequency for the carboxylic acid carbonyl group, that is around 1760 centimeter inverse, while in case of carboxylic acids, and the OH frequency in case of carboxylic acids non-hydrogen bonded, that is around 3550 centimeter inverse. So what will happen? Because of this dilution, intermolecular hydrogen bonding decreases because of this solvent, and if hydrogen bonding decreases, it absorbs at higher frequency. Because there is no hydrogen bonding, no weakening of the bonding, so there is no reduction of the stretching frequencies. It absorbs at the normal frequencies. So this is free from hydrogen bonding, absorbs at 3550 centimeter inverse. But this effect of dilution is not affecting the IR frequency of the orthohydroxybenzoic acid, because intramolecular hydrogen bonding is not affected by the dilution, because intramolecular hydrogen bonding, this functional group are very close to each other, so they forms hydrogen bonding automatically very fast, and this solvent will not enter in this region to disturb this hydrogen bonding. So dilution effect is not observed into the intramolecular hydrogen bonding. This dilution effect only observed into the intermolecular hydrogen bonding, because in intermolecular hydrogen bonding, that solvent molecule, a protic solvent molecule, intervenes the hydrogen bonds, intervenes the hydrogen bond. So in this way, dilution decreases the hydrogen bonding and increases the bond strength, and it observes as a normal frequencies. While in case of alcohols, phenols, similar to the acids, alcohols and phenols shows a strong hydrogen bonding effect. The hydrogen bonded alcohol groups shows a OH peak at the range around 3200 to 3500 cm. If IR spectrum of alcohols is measured in gas phase or extremely dilute solution, the aprotic solvents, the intermolecular hydrogen bonding disappears and OH stretching frequency to 3650 cm². So if hydrogen bonding is there in case of alcohols that absorbs at 3200 to 3500 cm², but if there is no hydrogen bonding because of highly dilution with the aprotic solvent, so it absorbs at 3650 cm². See here, suppose this is alcohol hydrogen bonded, then it absorbs near about 3200 to 3500 cm². This in case of phenol also same. But if there is a very dilution, extreme dilution or gases phase, if you measure the IR spectrum in gases phase, then this intermolecular hydrogen bonding is not there. This affects only intermolecular hydrogen bonding. The intramolecular hydrogen bonding remains same, that you should remember. So in this way, that affects in the stretching frequency of OH. Similar case for amines and amides also. This hydrogen bonding effects are also shown by the primary amines as well as secondary amines, and primary amides as well as secondary amides. Tertiary amines and tertiary amides do not have NH bonds, and hence hydrogen bonding is absent in case of amines and amides, which are tertiary. While same case happens into the amines and amides also, hydrogen bonding decreases the IR frequency, while on dilution it increases the IR frequency. Now you see the steric and strain effects on the vibrational frequency. First we start the steric effect. Usually this not important in IR spectroscopy unless they reduce the strength of bond, usually pi bond, by interfering with the proper orbital overlap. In this way, the steric effect is not important, not affecting into the IR spectroscopy. But if they are affecting the proper orbital overlap in case of pi overlap or pi bond, then it affects the IR frequencies. These are the two molecules, alpha, beta unsaturated ketones. In first, there is no any methyl group. In second, there is a methyl group. And because of this methyl group, what will happen? It makes a steric effect. And because of this steric effect, what will happen? The PP overlap, parallel overlap of this pi bond will get disturbed. PP overlap of this pi orbitals of this carbonyl-carbon, this carbon and this carbon will get disturbed. So planarity of the molecule will get lost. And as the planarity of the molecule will get lost, the resonance effect is also getting lost. Resonance effect decreases the IR frequency. If there is a loss in resonance effect, it increases the IR frequency. So see here the methyl group in the structure at the right cause the carbonyl group to be slightly out of plane, interfering the resonance. So plane of the molecule will get disturbed. As the plane of the molecule will get disturbed, there is a disturbance prohibition of the resonance effect. As the effect of resonance effect decreases, plus R effect decreases, then the vibrational frequency, stretching frequency of the carbonyl group is increases. That's why in the first molecule it's 1686 cm², while in second molecule is slightly higher, that is 1693 cm². In this way, by interfering the proper orbital overlap, that is p orbital overlap, parallel p orbital overlap is disturbed by the steric effect, and hence it absorbs at higher frequency. So this is how that steric effect affects the IR frequency. Next is the strain effect. Changes in bond angle forced by the constant of the ring will cause a slight change in hybridization, and hence and therefore the bond strength is also changed. As the bond strength is changed, their IR frequency is also changed. If bond becomes more stronger, then the IR frequencies increases. See here, for example, cycloheptanone, cyclohexanone, cyclopentanone, cyclobutanone and cyclopropanone. So from left to right, the ring sizes goes on decreasing. The ring size goes on decreasing. For the sp2 carbon, the normal bond angle is 120. The normal bond angle is 120. So in cyclohexanone, that will be maintained. So normal IR frequency is around 17-10 centimeter inverse. This is flexible molecule, so frequency is around that one only, 17.05 to 17.10 centimeter inverse. But as goes down, the number of carbon goes decreased. So size of the ring goes on decreased. So what will happen? There is a strain into the bond angles. And because of this strain in bond angles, the change in hybridization is there. So the bond angle decreases, the carbon becomes more electronegative, as well as less sp2 hybridized, that is bond angle less than 120, and that shifts the IR frequency towards the higher side. That's why as the angle strain increases, the IR frequency, the stretching frequency of the carbonyl group is also goes on increases. So see here, 17-10 in case of cyclohexanone, that increased in 17-40 in case of cyclopentanone, that increase more as the sizes goes on decreased. So 17-75 in case of cyclobutanone, and that is highest around 18-18 centimeter inverse in case of cyclopropanone. So in this way, the structural effects affects the stretching frequencies of the functional groups. Structural effects which are increasing the bond strength, then the IR values will get increased. But the structural effect, if decreased the bond strength, then IR value is also decreased. So in short, minus I effect increases the bond strength of the carbonyl group, so this it absorbs at higher frequency. Plus R effect decreases the double bond character, so it decreases the IR frequency. Steric effect disturbs the pp overlap in case of pi orbital, so resonance effect will get disturbed, so it absorbs at higher frequency. And in case of ring strain, as the ring strain increases, then also IR frequency R increases. In next lecture, we will see the applications of IR spectroscopy and we will solve some problems. Thank you, friends.